Welcome to a new video, and we are talking about the Mate 50 Pro and its latest camera update, or let's talk about software update that also improves the camera. I'm talking about the November security patches that arrived for the Mate 50 Pro, running the Chinese version here, but apparently also the Emotion UI, the global version, will get this version as well, with camera improvements for video, but also for photos. So I'm checking it out right now with the front-facing camera of the Mate 50 Pro 4K 30. What do you think? And by the way, I'm recording using the internal microphone because the internal mics are so good on the Mate 50 Pro, especially on the back-facing camera that I'm using right now here on this device, which has like the aperture mode that can change the aperture according to the circumstances. And now it's very, very bright here. The sun is basically reflecting from the river onto my face, so no need for a very large aperture. In fact, I think it is recording in f2 here right now. I will take some photos and will give you also a quick little overview about the photos as well here on this device, but just to see if you notice any difference in terms of video here on the Mate 50 Pro. How is stabilization? How are colors? How is focusing? Because I noticed some focus hunting issues in one of the previous videos that was like, I think, two versions behind this version here right now. So maybe they fixed this already. And we also switched to the ultra wide angle. I have to go behind the camera to do this. So now we are at the ultra wide angle, which also looks pretty fine, I think. And how stabilization, how are colors here? Do you notice any improvements in contrast to my previous videos that I did on the Mate 50 Pro? Sadly, I cannot do like a before and after because it's just like a bit hard to do. But what do you think about the video quality here on the Mate 50 Pro? And what we want to do is also maybe a little bit of a zoom test. Not sure what to zoom on. Maybe zoom on the big tower there. So let's go and zoom in. Smooth zooming here. One time zoom. Now we are at 4 times, 5 times, 6 times, 7 times. Switch lenses, as you can see. And 15 times zoom. And I can zoom even further. It was like staying for 15 times a bit. It's very, very stable still, but yeah, this is 15 times zoom and I can zoom out. See, switch lenses again. Now we are at one time zoom and it's pretty, pretty smooth also, the zoom experience here on the Mate 50 Pro. I think the aperture closed a little bit here as well again, maybe because of the sun. What do you think about the video quality here in general on the Mate 50 Pro? Do you notice any improvements on it? Write it down in the comments and let's check out the photos.
Let's take a look at the photos. I didn't prepare much here, as you can see here, but I took some photos and I want to present it to you. First of all, the ultra wide angle. You can see the ultra wide angle did not change much. It has still very good HDR. You can see the sun, very sunny day, and the reflection, and it looks spectacular, even like with the sun flare here. Pretty good. Sharpness is okay. Everything nice and good. It has some struggle with the focusing, but this is okay. Not much has changed for the main as well. I see the colors are very, very similar. Nothing has changed here. Good HDR as well. And I can zoom in even. I can see the detail level is also there. Pretty nice. 10 times zoom was the next thing that I was taking a look at because, yeah, zooming is one thing that was a bit struggling in comparison to the P50 Pro, and I still think it is, but they improved a little bit here on the 10 times zoom. Still have this smoothening out, so you don't have so much noise in the shot, but I think they reduced it a little bit, so it's not too smoothened out, and you get a little bit of more details here in this shot. But it's a subtle change only, and you can only see it if you do like a back and forth between the shots. The Darth Vader test, 3.5 times zoom, looks nice and sharp. I think a bit over sharpened eventually here. 10 times zoom shot is also okay, but you can see, yeah, the details is because of the smoothening a bit lacking, especially here on the rope that he has on. And the dog that walked by, I had to photograph him here as well, but you can see, yeah, the sun flare was just hitting the lens directly, so no chance there to get him nice and contrasting, but still it managed to have him focus, which is pretty nice, a nice dogger photo. Then the ultra wide angle, I think in this case the ultra wide angle is doing a little bit over processing in terms of sharpness. It looks a bit ugly, I have to say. Reminded me a bit of the Zenfone 9, to be completely honest here, with the over-sharpened look here, which I don't like so much, but the rest, like at least the sharpness is keeping up over the whole image, so this is okay. And HDR is nice and fine. I think the colors are okay as well. Maybe it had something to do with the sun. Then this raven I want to photograph. Is it a raven? I don't really even know. You tell me. 3.5 times, 3.5 times. Yeah, okay. You can see the over-sharpening a bit going on. 10 times is a bit better, closer. And I wanted to photograph. Yeah, can I photograph him picking up something? And as you can see, yeah, the shutter is quick enough also for the zoom shot at 10 times, so no issues there. Another 3.5 times shot. 3.5 times still better than 10 times, I would say, for the optical. Very, very good. And the 10 times, yeah, you get a little bit more of information here, but still the smoothening effect is going on here on the 10 times zoom shot. I try to photograph a plane passing by at 10 times. You can see I struggle a bit because moving subjects are still a problem for this. So the bird was fine. The plane that is moving here, when I have to move the camera, really, not the subject or object is moving, but I have to move the camera, then it's like struggling a bit. And this is 30 times. You can see it's basically unusable. Yeah. 10 times zoom here on this. Can you guess what it is? Let me zoom out. Yeah, looks like a branch here. Yeah, it's really a tree branch, as you can see, just to show you how this looks like, how far you can zoom in to, and it's looking pretty nice. As soon as I zoom in to 100% view, you can see, yeah, it's not really nice and sharp, but I think still on a 40-inch, 50-inch screen at full screen, not going to the 100% view of the photo itself, because it has like, what is it, 16 megapixels, it's still fine. So yeah, this is what you can get here. Then birds, bird photography as well. Zoom shots make sense. I photographed a little bit of birds here, 10 times. Could get a little bit closer. You can see it looks nice if I zoom in. Yeah, you can see even like this cross in his eye, which is pretty nice. But yeah, the details are a bit lacking. So let's focus maybe on this very nice 30 times zoom, 100 times zoom, I think now. Maybe it's 50 times here. And we have yeah, here a bit better details also in the feet, as you can see the feathers as well, but it's struggling a bit, and I think still the P50 Pro is doing a bit better job. More noise, but a bit better details, and I like more details instead of, yeah, smoothened out shot. Very nice here indeed to this 10 time shot. Yeah, you can zoom in, you notice a little bit of lag in terms of details still. You can see a lot of details, but yeah, this one is a very nice shot. Not at 100% for sure. This is 30 times zoom, something like this, 40 even. But as a shot itself, if you have it like zoomed out like this, pretty fine indeed. Selfies, portrait mode still doesn't have like a fake background bokeh here. You have the normal mode, you have the stage light mode, which is like cutting me out basically. And you have the photo booth mode, which I'm not sure what it's doing. Some yellow in my face, I think maybe a reflection in contrast to this one here. I really don't see much of a difference, I have to say. Yeah, if you want real bokeh, you have to use the backside camera, use the aperture mode, set the aperture to 1.4, and you get this nice creamy background bokeh with me, fully sharp, best selfie ever, because it's not using the selfie cam, it's using the main camera on the back. And yeah, this is what you can achieve with this one. What do you think about the photos in general? I think the Mate 50 Pro improved a bit, probably a bit more in terms of video than in terms of photo, especially stabilization eventually. But I don't see much of an improvement in terms of photos. Just the 10 times zoom, I think there's a little bit details added there, so it's not smoothing out so aggressively as it was before. But in general, the ultra wide angle and the main are basically the same. What do you think about the photos and videos? Write it down in the comment section. That's everything for this short little video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye.